Hello everyone and welcome to Generation 9. Pokemon Scarlet and Violet been out for just over a week as of the time of I'm recording this. And this is the start of a bit of a mini-series, or it's not going to be mini-series by the time I'm done with it. Fuck me. The editing alone is going to take me quite a while. This is going to be a Pokemon Scarlet hardcore Nuzlocke. I'm changing up the rules a little bit. I've already played through Violet, so it's not going to be a blind run. On my first runs, I tend not to want to limit myself by what I can do. I like to explore the region. And this is an open world game. You're not going to be able to do your usual stance of one Pokemon per route because the areas are so big that you're going to really limit yourself. And, you know, the game's still fresh. There's still a lot of Pokemon in this game I haven't used and I want to use them all. So, how are we going to handle this Nuzlocke? Well, first of all, it's going to be standard hardcore Nuzlocke rules. Obviously, set mode doesn't exist in this game for some reason. So, I'm going to have to do that manually. All the Pokemon are going to be named, obviously. If at any point they faint, I can no longer use them. They're considered dead. The usual. But also, because I want to use everything, I'm going to allow myself to catch one of every new Pokemon line, including their new evolutions. So, for example, I'm going to allow myself to catch a Mankey or a Pawniard, although I would not be catching a Pawniard because it takes so bloody long for it to become a Bisharp. So, fuck that noise. But with each, there are three different paths in this game. There is the Victory Road, the Path of Legends, and Starfall Street. So, how I'm going to manage it is every Pokemon I catch is going to be used for one of those paths. So, for example, catching a Lechonk puts it in the Victory Road path. Catching a Tarantula puts it in the Path of Legends storyline. And I can only use those Pokemon for each of those paths. And as you will see, I also have each of the three starters. And again, those starters can only be used for one path. And the way I handled it is Fuecoco, the red one, goes into Victory Road, which has a red border. Sprigatito, the green one, goes into the Path of Legends path, because it is a green border. And that's how we're going to be handling it. So, how is this series going to look? First of all, it's going to be this one video as the intro video, just to explain what's going on. And then I'm going to do a video for each of the three paths. I'm going to play everything in order with level caps as per hardcore Nuzlocke rules. But I'm going to separate each of the paths into their own video just so it's a bit more streamlined. And then there'll be one final video for the post-game. Hopefully it should be a lot of fun. We do have a bit of a naming theme going on in this. It's going to be basically just Spanish names and Spanish words. Hopefully you guys enjoy it. I'm going to enjoy playing through this game again. I have 100 hours on Violet. And Violet's purely going to be for doing raids and hosting my living deck. Scarlet as well as all the, pretty much all my challenge runs are going to be. I look forward to it. I look forward to you joining me on this journey. How long is it going to take me to get these videos out? I do not know. It took a fairly long time for me to finish off the United Shield playthrough, so maybe longer than that, maybe less. We're going into Christmas now, and you know, I work in hospitality, so I have no free time until after all the holidays are done. But yeah, I'm looking forward to playing through this. Looking forward to taking you with me on this journey. And I will see you guys in the very first video, which will probably be Victory Road. And then it'll be Path of Legends, and then it'll be Starfall Street. And then it'll be post-game. Thank you very much for watching. And I'll see you guys next time. Bye!